1971 Volvo 1800E. We call them all the P1800 just to make our lives easier. But this 1800E has leaking freeze plugs. Let's get to work fixing them.
Oh wait, what's this?
Another B20 with freeze plug problems.
Yay.
Removing these failures was actually quite easy. Just a couple of hoses, you keep track of things, and a few bolts on there. I just want to remark on how nice fuel injection is because it's running so clean in there. Ugh, I'm envious. There's a little bit of oil though. I think we've got some degree of blow-by happening or something else because it's nice and oiled here.
They look pretty clean as Colorado.
Well, that's not why we're here. We're here for the freeze plug. Look at that. Yum. 2 and 3 are not leaking, but 1 and 4.
1 and 4 leaking.
1 and 4 looking pretty rough. 1's the worst, and then there's a...
1's the first. First is the worst, isn't it?
Yeah. We have a nice puddle that's at the bottom of the bell housing from this guy here running down and along the side of the block. Okay. 134,000 miles. How long have you owned this car?
32 years.
32 years. Fabulous.
What, is it fun?
I think it's great.
And you know, I like this automatic. You know, when you hooked up the thing and it started working?
Oh yeah, we fixed the kickdown cable, so she really has some go now. Okay, freeze plugs are out.
Well, let's switch batteries on the charger.
Yep.
Not too bad, but it looks like it got painted in there before the plugs were installed.
And this is from the shop.
Yeah, from the old rebuild. And this is the RTV ring that sits around the plugs. And here they are. And that one's not awful. But these ones are actually sealed up nice and tight. These are the loose ones, and you can tell because the holes are smaller. Oof, a little bit of gunk in there, and a lot of bit of gunk in here. This one practically popped out on its own. Minimal effort. I got no space here. There's more swinging room at a local hangman's party than there is here. Yeah, that's a tough one. The other two went in okay. 4 hours later. Everything's in. Now we can start putting in our manifold spec. I'm encouraged by how easy it is to work on these cars. And another thing to do while you're changing freeze plugs, may as well check your sensor here because you want to get a good reading on your temperature. That one's looking pretty rough.
How's it going?
It's going well. New temperature sensor is in valve cover zone. Sometimes when you're putting on the valve cover gasket, this is difficult to line up with the holes, and then you end up moving it around too much, especially if you're using RTV. We're using a gray RTV on this cover. This is, I think it's aluminum, right, this cover?
Aluminum.
And it needs a little bit of RTV to help seal the cork around it. Just that's what we found over the years of using it. But only on this side, not on the head side. These little dowel pins here have been very helpful for getting that alignment to set down just straight on the gasket. The only trick here is avoiding the fuel line here. This 1800E also has a fan motor adapter for a more modern style, which required the spacer, so we are kind of working in a cramped environment. But this is a pretty good job for a second set of hands. Just gotta build up some fuel pressure, huh? I'll say that's even better than when we started, because we pulled something out of an idle sensor that shouldn't have been there.
remember that little plastic thing was adjusting this thermostatic cold idle valve. There, plugging this port. These two bypasses the throttle for a cold warm-up. But it's California, and if you have a faulty cold start valve, you might not need it unless you're out of state.
Hey, baby, what did you say? A boop-bop a burger. A shoe shop a shake. Ooh. There she goes.
Did you open the hood?
Oh yeah, she needs some help.
Okay. Yum. Oof, that is an oily turbo. Oof. Hee hee hee.
When I took out the one plug, it didn't seem like they put it in tight. I know it's aluminum head, so I didn't
want to
put it in tight, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Oh, and that's all on her own. I didn't touch the throttle there.
That's why
I was driving. Yeah, I can hear the turbo whistle a little bit. Really? Oh, didn't catch it in time.
It's old gas.
Very old.
Yeah.
You know, I like.
I'm surprised it runs.
I like this. Oh wow. Oh wow. Yes. Oh how nice. Look at that. The plastic suede. Two sunroofs. How do you operate the sunroof? Is there a button?
I'm sorry.
The sunroof?
I think the switch is above your head.
Does it work?
I don't know.
Oh, do you mind if I try?
No.
I see the switch here. Oh, it crawls. Okay. Oh, and it lifts. Okay. I'm not gonna force it until it probably gets. This is so. Look at that. That is so good. Wow. Okay.
Now these things. How do you tell if they're bad or not?
Day three, our third day.
Plugs are looking good.
Goop is dried. Time to add some coolant. Showtime. This is an old doorman plug. Look at that. 3361233. Yeah.
And this.
And now everything's rubber.
I realized that I forgot to close the hood while driving, but luckily you can do that. Oh boy. Automatic and it doesn't have a lot of power. It's got enough power, but you know, customer cars.
Yeah, it's getting a bit dark, but I just wanted to mention I get to spend the night with this little lady here and take her to work tomorrow. We've got about 100 miles. I'll be driving it and we'll see that the freeze plugs are fixed or not. Hopefully they are.
and everything should be copacetic. Except for that. Yikes, looks like I only latched one side. My brother is shopping for a Volvo, and I'm really happy to hear that. This is a T6, 300 horsepower, 325 feet of torque.
Your pants are the same color.
Oh, it's not bad.
I can't operate like this.
What's this for, dude?
A hanger. Discomfort. You could put a bar between the two.
And discomfort.
Oh, no.
It's so slow.
It's a Volvo.
That's nice.
You like? Are you even wearing pants?
No.
Uh-oh, try the sides. Oh, go on.
Are you gonna help?
Are you gonna make me wait?
I can't find it. Do you see it?
That's right.
Not much to look at. I mean, it's great.
That's the turbo.
Oh, that's what T6 means.
Mm.
What does turbo mean?
Fast.
Forced induction. Fast.
Yeah. Fast. Oh my gosh.
It's adequate.
I use my phone a friend to call Soren, and you are Soren. Soren's body double. And we were talking about why the AC compressor makes some noise in that XC60, and he was reminding me that it's linked to the alternator and it's a big repair. Something that'll cost $1,000 elsewhere, could be twice that price here in Cali. So we gave him a heads up and said no thanks, but what a great car, huh?
Yeah, it's really pretty on the outside.
And you know what I liked? Is that there's no pressure from these salespeople to do anything. They're just like, oh, no worries.
I like
keep
cars.
Looking. The wide angle's not the best. There we go. That's better.
Okay.
Customer states. Hesitation at idle. Weird.